going on? What's going on? What's going on? I had a road trip today. I was traveling for about 12 hours. I drove from Virginia all the way to Alabama for a wedding. And a whole bunch of news happened while I was on the road. Apparently, Jason Witten restructured his deal to free up $3.5 million in cap space, reportedly. And it looks like the Cowboys went ahead and are going to sign Cameron Fleming, which is a really great move to get your swing tackle. Now the Cowboys really just open themselves up to go ahead and get them a guard in the draft. They also free. I'm not sure what Fleming's deal is. If anybody has his deal, just go ahead and flash it in the comments. Let me know. That's a solid move. As a matter of fact, I think that the Fleming move is actually probably better than the Hearns deal, if you ask me. As far as getting the what's up, man? What's up? I am Infinite. What's up, VA Finest? Yeah. I think that that was a better move than the Hearns because now it just frees us up to just go ahead and get that guard that we need. We don't have to worry about a guard or a guard and a tackle. I think that it's just great. And I heard that the Cowboys aren't done in free agency. I think that there's another switch that they might be able to flip to create some more money. Let's hope that maybe it's my boy the linebacker. Maybe it's Bowman. I'm hoping. Let's pray. What's going on, guys? But what I want to do is I'm only gonna be on for a little bit, so let's open it up for a Q&A. Let me know what you guys want to discuss. I haven't been on all day. I haven't had a chance to do a video or anything. I just go ahead and shoot some questions, man, and let's get some stuff answered. Let's start a debate. I hope you guys got a chance to watch a couple of my videos yesterday where I talked about the Allen Hurns signing and how maybe one of the receivers has to go between Beasley, Terrence, and Dez. It's actually a head scratcher once you get a chance to look at the numbers. So go ahead and look at that if you haven't had a chance. I don't know, man. For me, I don't think that it looks good for Dez, man. Personally, I think that they're telling us that everything is straight. That's because the draft hasn't happened yet. The draft hasn't happened. And if they go ahead and get a receiver at 19 to get Ridley or DJ Moore, it's a possibility that Dez could be gone or they could very well trade Dez. Same thing with Beasley. But go ahead and watch that video and check out the numbers, man, because the numbers speak. What's going on, Jeremy? How you doing? What you think about that move, man? Yeah, see, AJ. Everybody keeps saying T. Will, man, but when you go look at the numbers, it just doesn't make sense. See, it's not that Dez is super underperforming or that Beasley's underperforming. The issue is that they re-signed Terrence last year when they should have let his ass walk. That's really the issue. If they would have let Terrence walk right now, we wouldn't have an issue. But because they signed him to that deal, they felt like they just couldn't move on without him. Now we're stuck in a situation where a better player is going to have to go, which sucks. But that's what we're looking at. And I just don't see the Cowboys. I just don't see them interviewing a whole bunch of those receivers and not drafting one or two. So we'll see, man. I just don't see it, man. Yeah, Brad. It's true. But you know what, though? I'm not going to say Dez is injury prone because you know what? He does get injured, here's the one thing about Dez that I love, and this is why I don't want him to go anywhere. This is me just speaking as a fan, and I'm not speaking from the business side of it. Dez gives you 110% of everything he has, man, all the time. He bleeds blue and silver, man. He wants to win for us. He gives everything for the Cowboys. That's the one thing about him, man, that makes it really hard for me to see him not in that uniform because I truthfully believe Dez would die on that field just to represent the Cowboys. What's up, Fred? If we get a receiver in the first three rounds, Dez is gone with 10 receivers. Yes, man. I truthfully believe that, man. 19, 50, and 81. The first three rounds are going to be filled with receivers that are really good, man. Think the Cowboys will be aggressive in the draft to pick up O-line. I didn't get a chance to see the rest of it, but that's a very it's a good possibility, man. I think Hernandez at 19 is going to be there, so they'll have an opportunity to get him. Brad Baker, 10 to 96, a lot of anyone, including Dez. Yeah, it does. The Root Guru, John, said that Dez does know the tree, but never asked to run it. Yes, it is the coach's fault. I truthfully believe that, man, VA's finest. And I touched on that. It's not Dez's fault, and it's not a lot of these receivers' fault that they're not innovative. And Romo pretty much talked about it in the interview with Brad Sham, where he pretty much talked about if you're in the same offense you were 5 years ago, you're in trouble. And I think Terrence said something about the play with Romo. When Romo was playing, the play didn't start until, I guess, everything broke down. So that really means that Romo was pretty much just going ahead and making plays on his own, which sucks because, I mean, we wasted his good years, man. We wasted his good years. We wasted T.O.'s good years. And it looks like we're wasting Dez's good years. So, but yeah, back to the signing. Yes, Cameron Fleming from the Patriots. My friend, one of my best friends, is a Patriot fan. And I first thing I did was ask him about Fleming. And he said Fleming has really good feet and he fit into their system really good. And he was a good player. And I think that he was a player that they didn't want to let go. So it's a good signing by us. And he's not going to start. He's going to be a swing tackle. Which is very great for us because we don't have to address that in the draft, which is great. I don't think Lyle will go back to guard unless we just don't draft a guard. So, but there's a couple of good guards in this draft that we can get and plug in from day one. Michael Perez, do I think the problem is Dak's accuracy a little bit? Absolutely. And part of that is what I was just discussing, which is the offensive line. If you look at it, Dak was throwing off his back foot a lot because he had pressure coming up through the middle. Dak had a lot more pressure this year, and you know, a lot of guys hated Doug Free, and we were okay with Leary going, but both of those guys, we missing both of those guys, and you see a lot more pressure. So I think that had a lot to do with it. VA Finest, yeah, I've been reading it all over, man. And normally, when you're reading it, I haven't seen Fisher report it yet, so I'm not sure, but I'm pretty sure that he's going to be a Cowboy. Yeah, Ron Smith. Yeah, Tyron's injury did have something to do with it, and that's why we got the swing tackle today. Should we trade for Earl Thomas or trade up in the draft to get James? That's a tough question for me, because I would love to get Earl Thomas. But at this point, man, if Seattle isn't playing ball, we got to go ahead and come up with some different solutions. And trading up for James, to me, is mortgaging your future a little bit. Even though I think that he's a really, really, really good special player, you'd have to give up your 50th pick. And I just don't think that giving up 50 right now with the way that our roster is a viable option. So, I mean, there's guys like Eric Reed out there who they just need to give a look. They just need to get over themselves with that whole anthem protest because the NFL got over it and they're donating money to the league. So, at this point, man, we got good players out there still. But maybe they're waiting until after the draft to see what happens to reach out to a guy like Burnett or Eric Reed. So, see if we get any more. Damn, we got 30 people on right now. That's what's up. Go ahead, feel free, guys. I got about a minute and a half left. I'm at a wedding. My wife, it's actually the in-laws. Andrew Castillo, yes, Vaccaro would be a really good signing, as a matter of fact. Vaccaro, I'm glad you brought him up because he slipped my mind, but Vaccaro's still out there, but maybe he's still out there because a lot of people are vying on trying to get Derwin James, so we'll see. That's probably what's happening. Derwin James and Fitzpatrick are really good players. What do I think about Benny Logan? I don't want another player with Eagles stink on them. You saw what happened last year. Every time we get an Eagles player, they stink. So what do you think about trading for a faster tight end or drafting one? I'm all about drafting one. I draft one because they have about five of them in this draft that could come in and do the job. See, I'm a little upset because we restructured Jason Witten's contract, which means we're kicking money down the road. I actually want a replacement for Jason Witten. I wouldn't be upset if they were to cut him at this point because it sounds funny, and don't kill me for it, but if they cut him, that would save us a lot of money in the future. And I think that Rico is ready. We're never going to know if somebody's ready until they allow him to play and they allow this to happen. So
It is what it is. Witten is getting a little old, getting a little long in the tooth, man. And we got to figure out if we can survive without him. And as long as he's on the roster, he's going to be smarter. He's going to be better than everybody on the roster. So we're not going to have a chance to develop anybody behind him. We do draft 19. I'm sorry, VA Finals. I lost that one. But yeah, man, I appreciate you guys for getting on. I probably won't be as occupied doing videos and stuff this weekend as I'm here at a wedding. But I appreciate it, man. Appreciate you all for tuning in. Just go ahead. If you haven't had a chance to watch some of my old videos, go ahead. Watch them. As of late, man, it's been a lot of fire. So go ahead. I really appreciate it. Hold on. Wait, one more. Why did they frown upon us getting a fullback? He's not necessary. Fullback, an extension to the O-line. They wanted a fullback. I'm not one of those people that are against getting a fullback. I thought that Odawale was a great signing. I liked him when he was here. I don't think they wanted him to go when he went to Oakland, but Oakland offered him such a good deal. And now we got him back, and I think the offense. He can also run the ball a little bit too, which I think that he might make Rod Smith expendable at this point because they're both kind of the same runner, but Odawale is a blocker. And you can put him in on third down situations to block for the quarterback, which is really good because he can run and block. So, and it gives us an opportunity with our 10 picks to go ahead and get us one of those speedy running backs that are in the draft like Penny or Hines out of North Carolina State. But all right, guys, thank you for tuning in. Peace.